Now, more and more moms and dads are paying for video game coaches for their children. Parents are reportedly hiring professional gamers up to $50 an hour to help sharpen their children's skills so they can win the popular online game Fortnite. One mother tells the Wall Street Journal about her son, quote, "There's pressure not just to play it, but to be really good at it. You can only imagine what that was like for him at school." Greg?
Okay, this is a, I know a lot of people think this is probably a bad idea, but it's not, it's a great idea. Video games for a child are superior to golf because it takes up less room. Golf is a very selfish sport because it takes up acres and acres. It's better than football because you're not gonna have any injuries. It's better than soccer because you can use your hands. But the most important thing about video games is that you have a child or a teenager who's playing it has a chance for a lucrative career. This is a huge industry, not just for players, but if you have tennis coaches, why don't you have video game coaches? With video games, it's an industry, it's a multi-billion dollar industry that provides careers. Playing, designing, marketing, selling, it's a huge arena. They should do this. It's a great idea. You're welcome. By the way, if you're the video game industry, you know where to find me.
Oh, they do.
Remember?
Oh yeah, they got mad at me.
Yeah, they got mad at you one time. But I told them that I said, if I were you, I'd just leave Greg alone.
Yes.
Every weekend.
Everybody says that.
Oh well, okay. I buy that, but in terms of like that's the industries of the future. If you're trying to think of like what are the jobs going to be in 20 years when your kids are playing. But here's something else that happened is that it's so obsessive. And it's also turning criminal. This one young 8-year-old was pressured into people that are playing online to go into his mother's purse, pull out her wallet, get her driver's license and her credit card, take pictures of them,
wow,
and then send them to the people. Now, the people that asked for them had not done anything with them yet, so the police say, well, there's nothing you can do because it's not illegal to give someone's private information out, but it is seemingly getting a little out of control.
But you can't blame the game. They blame the stupid
I'm not blaming the game. I'm just saying that people are obsessed.
If it was an older 8-year-old, that wouldn't have happened.
Well, college is unaffordable to a lot of people, so if you can invest 50 bucks and they can get a $1,000 scholarship, I'm all for that. That's an investment. I worry about them frying their eyeballs, though. If you're staring at screens and you're wiggling your little fingers and you're like in the you know, house all day, I disagree with Greg. Go play golf. Go play soccer, even soccer. Go play football. I'd rather have my kid in sunlight, sweating.
You're
with other people,
Jesse,
than sitting in a couch.
You're on TV saying
his fingers.
People are at home watching you. You don't want them to go outside.
I want them to watch me and then go outside.
Kids should be building forts and playing in a stream somewhere. What is video game? I played video games. You know what video games teaches us? It teaches us how not to look people in the eye when we speak to them. It doesn't teach us how to give a firm handshake. And it teaches us it's okay to wear pants with elastic in the waistband. And that is not all right.
That is not all right. You know, Jesse, this might be a we might make history. I actually agree with you.
Wow. Well, then I changed my opinion.
I'm sorry, Donald Trump. You guys just got to get with the times. There's no turning back on this.
But we didn't include the story that earlier this week there were parents who were hiring psychologists to come to talk to their children because their fear of losing was basically
overwhelming.
All right, you're going to have to get psychologists.
No, I remember being a kid and like going outside and throwing around the football and playing street hockey with my friends, and it built team building, camaraderie.
What if you don't like sports?
Exercise,
what if you don't like sports?
Like childhood obesity is a thing, and you're sitting in front of a television all day playing video games and eating.
But if you play Fortnite for a long time, you might forget to eat.
But can
this
we,
is the problem.
Those kids are happy.
But can we admit that these parents are paying for the kids' coaching in Fortnite because they're embarrassed by their kid because their kid can't play that well, and they don't want their friends coming out of the house and saying, God, your kid stinks at Fortnite.
This is like those courses for, you know, SATs. You know?
Yeah.
That's what it is.
Really?
Yeah, I think it is.
I
think video games will actually make a kid smarter than studying for the SAT.
No, it doesn't make you smarter.
Wholeheartedly disagree.
I have published papers on this.
Then video games.
I'm lying, but I
think it's more important to know Pythagoras' theorem than how to play Fortnite.
A squared plus B squared equals C squared.
I have that in my phone. I don't need to know anything. It's in my phone.
Mario Brothers, much better for your brain.
Only in Greg's world.
I like Pong. I'm old.
Only in Greg's world.